to for us. We will bring back all the glory and all the honor unto him. Are we together? So there is what the Lord expects from us, and there is what we expect from us, from the Lord. Amen?
Amen.
And I also was read in the book of 2 Kings chapter 6. 2 Kings chapter 6. 2 Kings chapter 6. And verse 1. We speak speed anointing in that table. 2 Kings chapter 6. Let's read all of us. One to go. The company of the prophets say to Elisha, look, the place where we meet with you is too small for us. Let us go to the Jordan, where each of us can cut a pole, and let us build a place there for us to live. And he said, go. Praise be to God. Bwana Yesu apewe sifa. Na nikajua ya kwamba katika nyumba ya kuabudu na kusifu tumeitwa na tumepewa jukumu ya kwenda kulete vikingi. Amen. We have been called to go and bring pots in the house of God. Amen. Aye. Bwana asifiwe sana. How many know that they are pots in the house of God? Lakini tumeitwa kwenda kuleta more. Kwa sababu the more the house is established with the poles, the stronger the house is. Are we together? Bwana apewe sifa. Kuna misingiti vingi mahali ambapo tunatoka. Wale majirani zetu ni misingiti katika nyumba ya Bwana. Amen. Wale tunafanya kazi pamoja ni misingiti katika nyumba ya Bwana. And we are not strong yet because some of the poles are still in Jordan. We need to go to the Jordan and bring the pots. And command and call the people. Invite people in the house of God. Witness to the people. Bring them to Christ. Amen. As they come to Christ, there will be pots in the house of God. Amen.
Amen.
Praise be to God.
Amen.
And we will be strong. And when we come to celebrate upon in the house of God, we will celebrate with joy. Amen.
Amen.
We will celebrate with confidence with our God. Amen.
Amen.
Praise be to God.
Amen.
Therefore, we are commanded. And because of our time, we want to spend our time well. I want you to turn to your neighbor and tell your neighbor, go and bring a post. And give him or her high ten. Give somebody high ten. Give somebody high ten. Kama unatumia mkono moja, unamsalimia mara mbili ndio ikuwe ten. Kama unatumia mkono mwingine unapiga moja pap. High ten. Hiyo ni ten. Amen.
Amen.
Give somebody high ten. High ten. Bwana asifiwe sana. And let us put our hands together for Jesus. Give a fish. Take our fish. Waweza kutupitishia the kipindi ya kuimba happy birthday. Amen. Amen. Sunday church. Ni nyinyi tunangoja tukomboe time.
Hamjambo.
Tujambo.
Sawa.
We are here today for a very special event that we're going to celebrate those children who were born in the month of September. And we want you to be excited in the house of God, because this is about, the kingdom of God is about children. Eh? So before that, we're going to just sing one song, and then one person will present a short verse, then we shall be done. We want to spend the least time possible, so because we know we don't have a lot of time. Okay. So please, let's have the song. I'm done.
Praise God. Amen. Praise God once more. I have a memory verse from the book of Zacharias 8:12. It says, I am a seed, I will grow well, and I will increase to be a great nation. Amen.
Amen. Amen. It's a seed. These are seeds. Bwana asifiwe. Na tunashukuru Mungu. We want to go right away to those who are celebrating the birthday. I want to have a blessing to bring them here. Come. Tuwapigie makofi za watu wana celebrate birthday. Birthday. Aya. Mama hapo. We are going to sing for them. Happy birthday. Come on first. Listen. This is Mofat. Aya, tutawaimbia. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy
birthday, dear Mofat. Happy birthday to you.
Sauti. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Mofat.
Watoto wengine wote ambao Bwana umetupa kama wazazi katika nyumba yako. tunafurahia kuwaona wakikua katika jia zako. Tuwabariki walimu wa Sunday School ambao wamejipea kulinda hawa watoto na kuwakuza kwa jumba yako. Jehova walinde na wapa hekima hata zaidi. Tunawaombea hekima hata wakati Bwana wakiwa shuleni, wakienda shuleni kila asubuhi, wale walio shuleni boarding, walinde wote na watende mema na wakushane na maovu, kwani tumeomba kwa jina la Yesu Kristo Bwana mkombozi wetu. Na kila mmoja aseme amen.
Less than a minute, and then we need. Who was here in the cashier on Friday? You are. Our brother will give us a cashier on Friday's cashier, and one of you will give us a cashier, a report on your mission. That's very fast. Less than a minute.
Amen. Amen. Bonus. Kwa wazima. Mina ito Sam.
Hamuongereshi huyu ndugu kuanzia tena.
Mina ito Sam.
Mwingine bwana sifiwe.
Bwana sifiwe.
Amen.
Kwa Yesu ni bwana. Tuliona Nakuru kesha. Amen. Baadaye kwa kesha moja ya nguvu sana. Tuliona Mungu. Mungu akatunenea. Tukakuwa na wakati mwema kama wazee, Bishop Mark alikuwa na wengi wote. Bwana sifiwe. Though tukienda baadaye kulikuwa na challenges zingine, tulikutajamu mahali pale Maimayu. Tukakaa almost 2 hours, but Mungu, tukomba Mungu pawe na jia, na pakawa na jia. Actually tungekufa moyo, tungerudi. Lakini Mungu alisaidia kwamba tulikuwa kare, na tulikuwa bold, na tulikuwa determined kwenda mahali pale. So, Mungu abariki sana. Na hata kuna kitu moja, Pastor, sijuka nililia rais tukiwa na Pius. Na nikawambia, kuna Bishop, I think Bishop George. Alisema ya kwamba aliongea tu kidogo, akasema ni wakati wetu wa divine birth, mwezi wa tisa. Hivyo tu akaongea kitu kingine divine birth, nikasema wow, it was a confirmation from the Lord. Bwana asifiwe. So Mungu ananena, barikiweni sana.
Amen. Pia bwana makofi. Thank you. Bwana asifiwe. Nasema bwana Yesu asifiwe.
Amen.
Ya tunashukuru Mungu. Friday tulikuwa hapa kesha na ilikuwa nguvu, tuliomba na tukapokea neno kutoka kwa dada yetu. It was about obedience, but at the same time tuliomba kwa ajili ya kujazwa upya na Roho Mtakatifu, maana tunaelewa kwamba bila nguvu za Roho Mtakatifu hatuendi mahali popote. Kwa hivyo ninawahimiza wale ambao tumelala, turudi, kwa sababu ni wakati wa kuomba, especially after this message ambazo tunasikia hapa. We cannot afford kuendelea kulala tena. Maana tumeambiwa maombi ndio ina separate between boys and men. Kwa hivyo mimi nataka kuwa man indeed. Amen. Kama wewe unataka kuwa woman indeed, basi tupatane hapa kwa kiwanja ya maombi. Thank you.
Amen.
Pia bwana makofi. Thank you Julius. Thank you so very much.
Bwana asifiwe. Bwana asifiwe tena.
Amen.
Yeah, sisi vijana nasi tumekuwa na mpangilio fulani ambapo tunataka kuanzisha kupeleka injili katika maeneo haya ya Dagoretti Corner na vitongoji vyake kwa sababu we believe that this is the heart of God. God is after those people that are out there. So we have formed a group of people, and if you are there and you want to join us, you can also do it. There are people who are here and they want to be taking their Saturdays to Kwage to Kipeleka outreach, so that other people also can know the word of God. Actually, out there we thought that it is not possible. We came to discover Kwamba, as much as we think churches are all over the Goreti corner and there are people starting churches, we discovered that inside those houses hakuna neno la Mungu. So wakati tulienda, tukapatana na watu, they were willing to join us in our services, and I'm glad in the first service I saw some people that we met out there. So this is Outreach Club that has begun, and we want to call upon the youths because the youths are energetic and strong. Kwa hivyo kama uko pale wewe ni youth, come and join us. You can see me, you can see Gabi, you can see even Matenge. We are here and we can move together. Amen.
So jana mlienda witnessing.
Tulienda witnessing.
Uh-huh.
Areas are happening.
Yeah. Praise God. Wapigieni makofi. Now you are talking. For the very first time, I have felt excited by the youth in the house of worship and healing. Yeah. Honestly, let me better be open with you. Amen. Because that is what I have been saying. Until we rise up and we do sorrow. Until we rise up and do witnessing and soul winning, we are not doing anything.
Back to you.
Amen.
Amen.
We are so busy. Every week. Going to our businesses, going to our offices, going to our whatever, doing so many things. By the time we gather here, mpaka mtu anasinzia because asubuhi uliamkia kufanya kazi yako. Huh? You are already dozing. You are so tired. But if you are asked, what is it that you do for the kingdom of God? You have nothing.
It is bad.
It is wrong. It is time we rise up. We come here
to
pray,
to ombe,
seek the face of God, and walk with God. And join our youth. It's not only for the youth, for your information. It is going to be a huge thing. And I can assure you, my support is going to be fully on that team. And I want people who are going to join that witnessing team. Now look, you see some empty seats behind you. As far as God is concerned,
kama vile mwana wa usika,
he does not see empty seats here today.
Yeye haoni viti vitupu hapa leo.
Are you hearing me?
Yes.
God does not see any empty seats.
Mungu haoni viti vitupu.
God is seeing a full house.
Mungu anaona nyumba ambayo imejaa.
Leave alone that.
Sio hiyo peke
yake. I want you to know this, and I'm going to say it again and again. I am believing God for a 1,000 seater tent.
We are
going
to put it here. Kwa hema ya watu kuketi 1,000.
And it is going to be full in the first service and the second service. Every Sunday we are supposed to be adding chairs and at least one empty seat so that God, the other Sunday, can bring another person to sit on that seat. But they are not supposed to remain empty. And that is how church growth manifests. And I have seen it myself. How many are together with me? So those people who are not here, they are not here because somebody did not do their work. You never to invite somebody to church, you never invite to witness to somebody, you never preach it to somebody. And we are in for a time of divine birthing. Now this time of
amesema is what I've been speaking here. I told you, I believe God is saying we are in a season of divine body.
Ndio nimekuwa nikihubiri hapa ya kwamba ninaamini Mungu tuko katika wakati wa kuzaliwa.
Now one of the things with me is that once I hear God, I know I have heard God.
Moja,
and I follow that.
Ndani yangu ni kwamba nikisikia Mungu mimi najua nimesikia Mungu na nafuatilia.
Amen.
Amen.
How many are with me? Blessed be the name of the Lord. And exactly that is what Bishop Gigi Gichana confirmed this week on Friday. He said we are in a season of divine body. In fact, alisema a woman gives birth after 9 months. This is a season of divine body. That's what he said.
Alielezea vizuri kwamba mwanamke.
And he knows what God has been speaking here.
Hawajui yale Mungu amekuwa akiongea nasi hapa.
How many understand what God is saying? Blessed be the name of the Lord. So please join that team.
Tafadhali ungana
na ile team. Do it on your personal level.
Sio kuungana nao pekee, fanya pia kibinafsi.
That office where you are working.
Ofisi ni mahali.
Huyo neighbor wako, huyo customer wako, huyo jirani yako, huyo rafiki yako. Call them. Call them. Bring them to house of God.
Wapigie simu waite kaka nyumba ya Bwana.
In Jesus name.
Katika jina la Yesu.
And when we commit ourselves to the house of God.
Na tunapojitolea kwa nyumba ya Bwana.
Other things are going to follow us.
Mambo mengine yatatufuata.
How many are together with me? Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Now Perusu. Just stand up, please. And I want you to sing this song. I heard you sing it. And I know you. I don't know whether you are teaching praise and worship or you are the one who sings it. Nionyeshe njia zako, nikujue zaidi. Bwana, niwe kama wewe. Nionyeshe njia zako. Let's sing that song. Just lead us out, but then I'm going to bring the word, please. name.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Is that your cry? That the Lord will open your eyes. Blessed be the holy name of the Lord. Father of life, bring me closer. Lord, my heart is set on you. Let me learn the lease of time with your life unfolding mine, and at the peace of God, let it live. Thank you.